Welcome back everyone, I'm Bee. Today I have a new video on my series of how-to, and this time I'm going to show how to implement an user interface, and specifically I'm going to show how to create this common user interface with a typewriter effect that is very very common on games. The class that we use to create user interface is called Widget Blueprint. I have the example over here. And because I like to create things in C++, I think it's this way you can organize the code better rather than having everything in the blueprint. And this is no exception. So I like to have my widgets blueprints with a C++ on top of that. And there is another reason. If you have a widget blueprint that is based on a C++ class, if you want to connect that user interface with another element on the game, for example, another actor in C++, you have that connection through classes. If you have everything on blueprint, it's not that simple to connect elements. Let's take a look at the widget blueprint. So this specific widget blueprint is simple. It only has the main canvas, a background with that complete image, with a scale box to have the background scale with an aspect ratio, and the text. This is the text that I'm going to manipulate on the C++ class. I have an advice when you want to create widget blueprints and C++ and connect them with C++. The way I do it is I create first the widget blueprint, just the blueprint, then I place the elements and I set the names of the elements that I'm going to connect with C++. So in this case, the only thing that I'm going to connect with C++ is this element. So I make sure that I set this name first things before doing anything else. So what I will do is first create the widget blueprint, and we go right click, user interface, widget blueprint, and we start including those elements. For now, we just have the widget blueprint. We don't have the C++. Class connected, and we can see that here. So the parent class of this widget blueprint is user widget. In the case of this widget blueprint, the parent class is typewriter effect widget. Now, how can we create that class, C++ class? Right click, new C++ class. We need to click on show all classes, look for user widget, there we go, select it, set the name, and create the class. The way we connect that C++ class with the widget blueprint is we just need to go to the graph, click on the class settings, and select the parent class. So that's the class that I created for the other blueprint. If I connect this now, I might have a crash on the editor because I don't have any elements on this particular widget blueprint. That's why I said it's important to create the elements that you want to connect with the C++ class first, and then do this connection. That way, nothing is gonna break. So you can do it in that way. Let's move on now to the C++ class. So here we have the widget blueprint, the parent class, and here we have the code. This typewriter effect widget extends from user widget. And first thing we see on this is this property, this U property. This is the U text block message text that I have on the widget blueprint. So we have over here the same name, and that's how both elements are connected. And the way you do it is with just simply this U property meta. So it's meta bin widget, and you can connect more things, images, scrolls, buttons, anything you want to modify or do anything on the C++. And UUserWidget is slightly different to an actor. It doesn't have beginPlay, it doesn't have pick, it has different methods. One of them is this initialize. This will be similar to the beginPlay on an actor, but in this case it's just to initialize. The other element that is slightly different from an actor is the tick. In this case, what we can use to use that ticked function is the native tick. It has the delta sign like in tick. And I never use this, so I know exactly what is the purpose of that. So this function will run every frame. For the actual effect, what I have is this method, which is public and is blueprint callable. And it's the method that I use to set the specific message that I want to show with that typewriter effect. Before I keep explaining the code for this effect, I'm going to show how to connect the widget blueprint with the project. There are different ways that you can do this, depends on your game. In this case, I went for something simple because I wanted to have the user interface as soon as I click play. So the way you can connect that is through, in this case, is through blueprints. And a nice place to do that in this case is the level blueprint. So if I go to blueprints, open level blueprint, we can use this this way. So in the event begin play, I create the widget blueprint. So I just need to type create widget. And select the widget blueprint that way. After that, we need to add that widget blueprint to the viewport. So the node we need is add to the viewport. So add to viewport. Okay. And finally, we can call that blueprint callable function that I had on the code. So I just need to get that value, which will be the widget blueprint, and find that function. That's it. So I'm just gonna copy this text to have the same. Can compile. If play, I have the same thing. This is one way to connect the user the widget blueprint. There are others. We can do this for good, but for the purpose of this video, fine. In next videos, I'll probably show different ways and how to connect a player controller with a widget blueprint. Let's go back to the code and check what's the logic behind this show message function. I received the complete message on this parameter, which is a string. I keep a reference to that on this message show because I will use this string, fstring, to show its letter each time. This is an integer that I use for each letter on this message to show. And finally, this is the current message that I'm gonna show on that message text on the widget blueprint. So as soon as I call this function, I simply set its element. the message, the letter index is the first one, and the current message is nothing at the moment, it's empty. I use this text to show the current message, and I need to convert from string to this type. This is the way you use the message text or the uText block from the widget blueprint. This float indicates the time between each letter, the time between the previous letter and the next letter. And finally, this is just for the tick to indicate that we can start showing the message. This float is defined over here, and we can manipulate this from the widget blueprint. So this will indicate how fast the letters are shown. Let's move on to the tick, or the native tick. Okay, first thing is to use the delta time to update this current time between letters. When this current time between letters reaches the delay between letters, it will add one more letter. So I take the current message, which starts empty. I take the complete message and I take the index of the letter. It will start in the first one, and every time we will add one. So with this plus equals, I can add the next letter. And next thing is just simply the set again the current message. So it will start empty. Next time that this logic happens, it will have a new letter, and go on and so on and so on. After that, we just need to increase the index of the letter. And finally, we just check if the lender the index of the letter has reached the end of the message with this length. This will give us the total length or the number of letters inside that string. And this means that we have completed the message. So we set this boolean to false, so it will stop. If this is not true, we just reset the timer so we can go back. And that's it. So let's check again the effect. We press play, we can see the message. Now we can, for example, change the type of message. For example, that's a different message. Yeah, so we can make the letters faster. We can go to the widget blueprint, we can go to the graph, and we have over here the delay between letters. So for example, we can make this slightly faster and goes faster. We can make it slow. One, two. Then it goes slow. And that's it. With this simple example, you can integrate this for your games, and you have two characters talking to each other. You can use this simple code to represent this fun effect. That's it for this tutorial and for today. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, share, and hit that bell button to get notifications for next videos. Thanks for watching, and see you next time. Bye!